We begin with breaking news.
$3 billion for road improvement.
Devastating accident happened.
When it comes to the state of journalism in Seattle, what should the headline read?
It's extremely challenging.
Seattle Post-Intelligencer columnist and blogger Joel Connolly should know. He's been at this job for 46 years.
Donald Trump will not allow me to retire.
Beyond reporting on politics and the environment, the toughest story Connolly has been a part of happened 10 years ago, when the PI slashed its staff to become an online-only publication.
Filled something empty in my stomach because I've always seen it twofold, that I cherish the people I work with and I cherish my job. And I still had a job, but at the same time, people I cherished were leaving.
The PI now has a staff of 8, down from 170. A frustrating turn of events for a reporter who can clearly see the writing on the wall.
With the advent of the internet and so on, the classified advertising disappeared. And with it, a great deal of the income of the paper. So we shrank and we shrank.
It's not that Connolly and other reporters are any less dedicated to their work. It's just that their work is undergoing a revolution.
We all have a stake in the future of Seattle journalism.
Associate Professor Matt Powers is studying that issue. He teaches ethics and comparative media in the University of Washington's Department of Communication.
Rethink what it means to be a journalist today.
He recently convened a panel from the Seattle Times, KUOW, Crosscut, and the news website The Evergrey to discuss what he sees as a crossroads of possible futures for local journalism.
I'm simultaneously optimistic and concerned.
The concerns are a nationwide issue affecting all media.
Reporting live in Seattle.
The Pew Research Center found nightly TV news audiences have dropped by half between 1980 and 2004. In 2016, researchers found only 5% of 18 to 29-year-olds often get news from print newspapers, compared to 48% of those age 65 plus. And so-called new media is getting hit hard, too, as sites like HuffPost and BuzzFeed are cutting jobs right alongside more traditional news sources.
Almost every news organization is restructuring.
Powers says, with the massive amount of choices we have for news, it's easier for people to find options that align with their political preferences or simply tune out completely.
And so that means that, you know, aside from maybe what happens on your Google search or in your social media feeds, you can be largely just excluding news from your diet on a day-to-day basis.
Idea is simply to talk about opportunities.
Powers points to some of the innovative paths journalists are seeking, from crowdsourcing revenue to reaching out to new audiences, as some of the many ways to sustain local news.
I suspect there will not be a single clear solution, and it's one that I think is really crucial because it will shape in important ways the amount of chance there is for journalists to do quality journalism.
But what's it like trying to change the news media from the ground up?
First of all, don't try this at home.
Erica C. Barnett writes and publishes the C is for Crank political news website, and she's very clear about what you'll find there.
I am biased in favor of compassion for homeless people. I am biased in favor of housing, and I am biased in favor of safe streets.
After nearly 20 years working for alternative news outlets like The Stranger and the online site Publicola, she struck out on her own with the C is for Crank in 2015.
And it's financially sustainable, which is not what I would have expected necessarily 3 years ago going into this.
Barnett has more than 500 supporters via Patreon, a crowdfunding membership platform, and takes in donations in other ways too, to support what she calls her style of deep dive journalism.
It's seen as a new model, but it's really not that different than NPR, you know, KUOW asking for donations, Crosscut asking for contributions, or any number of websites now.
That includes the 123-year-old Seattle Times, which has just started a $500,000 investigative journalism fund to sustain its award-winning work in news.
Advertising is not the way of the future.
Barnett says her personal business model might not work for everyone. But she says the job of connecting with readers and gaining their personal support is the story of the future.
We have to change the model, and I believe that the right model, or part of the right model, does have to include directly appealing to readers.
Joel Connolly is part of that change, too. He endows a $1,000 a year prize for environmental journalism, named after his late mother, a reporter herself.
So I'm subsidizing my profession.
It's all part of a new reality that's trying to respond to an old truth, Connolly quotes from St. Thomas More, that silence gives consent.
Without participation, without insight, without holding people account, this country can't function.